What's up, everyone? Razzle here, coming to you from Ark Survival. And today, guys, what we're going to do is we're going to do something a little bit crazy. We are going to craft us a lovely 100% authentic assault rifle. Yes, yes, yes. I have been gathering supplies. Oh, man. Maybe that is right. Let's go to weapons. I've been making freaking cementing paste for like, seems like a century. There it is. Bam, baby. Turn it on. Make that puppy. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah. Now I gotta figure out how to make bullets. 3 ingots, 9 gunpowder. Well, just so happens. There it is. There it is. There it is. There it is. All right. Now, just so happens, somewhere around here, I've got gunpowder. I'm not gonna build, but you know what I could do? Gunpowder. More charcoal. I need more spark powder. 1 spark powder. I'm out of everything. I'm out of flint. I'm out of everything. Let's see here. Let's see here. Let's see here. Let's see here. Got 144 charcoal. I'm going to make some more gunpowder, guys. But first, we're going, while this is making, we'll make all the gunpowder we can. It takes 9 per bullet. So roughly saying 9 per bullet, 9 times 9 is 181. So I got enough for like 9 bullets right there. So we'll let that stuff make there. Put the gunpowder in hell. Weapons, ammo, and this is for medium caliber modern bullet, primarily used for fabricated rifles. We're gonna turn it on. We're gonna make our 9. Maybe we're not gonna make our 9. No, one thing, boy, I'm blowing through the metal. So it's not going. Oh, I got 9 bullets. Yeah. Let's turn it off. Let's go over and check on this. 58. 9 times 6 is 54. 59. 60. 61. 62. 63. Boom. That's 7 more bullets. And these things right here are freaking like, they're like treasure. They really freaking, they really value their bullets. We'll turn it off. We got 9 bullets, guys. Or 16 bullets. That's all we got. But what we're going to do today is I really believe... Let me give you guys a brief overview of what's happened on the server. All right, I took a 3-day sabbatical on the server. I didn't play anything for 3 days. And when they released 1.8... everything changed, because at that point, I think it's 1.8. Might be it's 1.79. I don't know. Anyways, I didn't play it on 1.79. Last time I played it was on 1.78, I believe. Well, I think it was 180. I didn't play it on 179, but I believe one. What the heck is that? Never noticed that before. Anyways, so what happened was, I've changed the server settings. I've changed the amount of XP. You get 1.25 XP now and I decreased the food intake and the water intake on humans. I did not mess with it on the dinos. I changed the craft or the taming speed to 1.5, which is so basically 1 is normal, 0.5. So basically, taming dinosaurs takes half the time it used to. And we'll get into that in a minute. But what I did in to offset that is because I felt like it was a little cheaty. You know what we need to do? This right here. Since I felt it was kind of cheaty, what I did is I in turn turned around and increased the number of dinosaurs. I think one is normal, and I increased it to like 1.8, so there's like a ton more dinosaurs. But not only did I do that, but I also increased the difficulty. So the base difficulty is on 0. I had it up to 0.6 last night. And I came across some pretty high level dinos. We killed some like a level 63 Carno. We were killing like level 40 and 50 Trikes. And things like that. I determined last night after running around, and I'll show you the dinosaurs in a minute. I determined after running around for a few minutes last night that I need to increase the difficulty even more. Because I still felt like I was a little OP. Don't get me wrong. There was a few instances where I was really worried we were going to die. You'll see it here in a few minutes, because let me look here real quick. This is east. We're gonna go north. We're gonna go that direction toward the Brono, and we did tame a Brono the other night. Now, with that being said, when it gets hairy is when you come up against a trike that's like a level 30. The level 30 trike really has nothing for a Spino or a T-Rex, or for that matter, Ben. Ben is like level 52 now. Ben ranked up like 5 times last night. Now, a little bit of that did have to do with the XP multiplier, but a lot of that had to do with the amount of dinos we were killing. Where it gets really risky is whenever you come up against a trike that's like a level 30, and he's got buddies. There was an instance last night where I felt like Gertrude and Godzilla and Ben, all three were gonna die. I was fine. They really didn't hurt me that much, but they weren't going for me. They were going for the dinos. So I really was worried at one point. I literally had to take the guys away from everything and force feed them to pull their health back up. Because what happened is because I've increased the number of dinosaurs that are out there, when we came up against that level 30 trike, he had about 6 other buddies with him, and they were all like level 19s, level 20s, level 26s. There was even like a level 40 in there. And don't get me wrong, these dinosaurs can smash a level 40 trike with no problem. Probably 2 hits and he's dead. But the problem is while he's killing one, you've got 5 others that are hitting him. And when it comes to level 30s and 40s on trikes, they're doing damage. They're doing a significant amount of damage. So I think Ben was down to like 150 hit points. And I think Gertrude and Godzilla were down to like 350, which may not seem like a lot, but when they've got 14 and 1500 health, that is a lot. So that changes things up tremendously. That has been pretty much the only changes I have made, other than I have changed the amount of XP, not the amount of XP, but the amount of engrams you get. And what I've done is I went through and I found a thing called, it's called, I think it's called Arc Admin Let me look it up real quick, and I'll tell you guys. It's called Arc Admin Command Pack version 1.14. If I can find a link to it in the if I can find the link to it, I'll put it in the description. But basically, what it does is it gives you a spreadsheet that you pretty much go in and you enter in the commands that, or not the commands, but the experience levels you want to get at each level. So basically, I think the highest that you could get was level 65 on the default game. I think 65 is where it tops out. Okay, with dinosaurs, what happens is you got a base of 40 levels past the rank that you find them. So basically, if you had like, okay, take Fritz for instance. We're just going to use Fritz as a baseline. Fritz got an upgrade. Say I took Fritz, and Fritz was a level 10 when I tamed him. On the default game, he could go 40 levels past that. So the max that Fritz could be was a level 50, and that was it. He would top out at level 50. Okay, and the same goes for, like, Stripes. I'm not sure who I'm on. But anyways, I'm going to increase his health. I'm going to increase Lucky. I'm going to increase Lucky's melee. Because I want all these I want all these cats hitting about 500 or so. But anyways, so basically, you could only go 50 levels up. Now, where I've changed that is when you do engrams. 2, 3. Hang on a second. I'm missing a cat. I'm not. Simba's over here. Where you change that is when you introduce your own custom levels. So basically what I did is I took the game and I said, okay, I want it to go beyond level 65. So what I did is the max level is 100. That's the max level for humans, and that's the max level for dinosaurs. Now what that means is, that means now that Fritz was a level 10 when I got him. Just for instance, I don't even know what he was when I got him, probably like a level 2 or 3. Do this right here. So let's do this, and let's say whistle neutral. So I'm gonna change all my dinosaurs to neutral. But basically what this means is now he can go 70 levels. So basically, if I got Fritz when he was a level 10, he can go now 70 levels, which he maxes out at 80. Okay, the XP, the amount of XP needed does not change. That I did not make that easier. I did not technically make the game any easier. I just made the reward more beneficial. So basically now, when I'm a 61, I believe. Yes, I'm a 61. So basically what happens is now when I hit 62, I'm going to get more engram points than I previously would. That's what I did. But what I've done is I've made it possible to unlock every engram on here. So basically I can unlock everything. There's no restriction on what I can buy, so I can literally just willy-nilly go through here and choose everything. And once I hit level 100, not even level 100, probably when I hit level 75, I will have enough engram points where I could have bought everything. Because the possible amount of engram points is like 6,600, and the amount that you need in the game is 2,200 or 2,300, if I do recall correctly. It might be like 2,324, something like that. So that's the changes on the server. Now, like I said, it's not any easier by any means. I want the game difficult. I do not want the game easy. I want the game so difficult that whenever I cringe to go outside these walls. That's what I want. I want to know that when I walk outside these walls, that there is a great possibility that I could die. That's what I want. Previous to yesterday, I did not have that feeling. Previous to yesterday, I would go out at night, I would run around, I would do this, and I would do that. I did not care. It did not matter, because any dinosaur that I came up against, I would kill. Even my cats were the same way. My cats would pretty much demolish anything that came in their path. And they're level 33s and 34s. I mean, they're not anything crazy. Now, it's not like that. Now, don't get me wrong. There's six cats. There's a really good possibility that they're going to live. At least the three that's level 30 and above. I'm not really sure about the other ones. But I'm increasing them. So what they're going to do is they're going to sit here and get, they're going to sit here idle and rank up slowly but surely until like they become level 25s, and then I'm going to take them out. But that's not the point. The point is I wanted the game more difficult. Now, granted, yes, I cut down the consumption the consumption of food and water. But as you can see, I'm still draining water, just not at the rate that I normally would. And I drain food too. But the dinos, they eat just as much. That has not been decreased. They eat just as much as they did, so that's not been decreased. I've not done anything with like how hard they hit. They hit the same as they normally would. The only thing I've done is I've made a few tweaks to make the reward well worth the fight. And so basically you upgrade when you level up and you get a possible upgrade, you're going to get more ingram points. There's going to be more reward, but there's also more of a risk. And the risk being that you're going to have to go out and fight higher dinosaurs. Now, I do not know what is in store for me today because I have not been outside the walls today. I spent probably the last hour to hour and a half doing nothing but making cementing paste and gunpowder for the guns. Because I want to use this gun. Now, I don't know if the gun's good or bad. I don't know. I don't have a clue. But I'm going to find out. And I'm going to bring you guys along with it. Because we're going to go north today. And we're going to go into some uncharted territories I've never been before. I don't know what's here. I don't know what to expect. But what we'll probably do in the meantime, and I'm just doing, while I'm talking to you guys, I'm just checking these berries to make sure they all have two things of compost, because I don't want them to run out. I'm not worried about the water. They're not going to run out of water, so I'm not worried about that, but I am worried about them running out of compost, and you know, we've got a significant amount more dinosaurs than what we had, so. But one thing that did turn up is I turned up the harvesting just a little bit on the dinosaurs, meaning, not the dinosaurs, the dinosaurs you kill, meaning that whenever you kill dinosaurs, you get more meat than you normally would. And I believe that naturally goes up anyways as the dinosaurs become more difficult. That's got two now. So I'm not really worried about that so much as I used to. So, I mean, it's nothing, you know, last night we went out for about 2 hours on a run and we came back with like 50 stacks of meat or something like that. It was something crazy. And I've had to put more preserving bins up there for all the meat just because there's just so much more. Now, like I said, I'm going to introduce you guys to the new dinosaurs. And I know this is kind of running long for, you know, it's been kind of talky, but I wanted you guys to know what I've changed on the server, because there's a lot of hype out there right now for the changes that you can make to the server. And I didn't want you guys to see me ranking up like crazy and be like, man, Razzle sure is ranking up a lot. I mean, he is ranking up a metric boatload. And so I didn't want you guys to think that I was cheating by any means. I'm not. I've just made some changes. Now, here is Gertrude and Godzilla. They are both Spinos. Now, let me tell you about these two. These two are a product of other dinosaurs. Meaning, I got these dinosaurs off of them attacking other dinosaurs. So pretty much both of these guys were out in the water swimming around, not really minding their own business. They were killing fish, and pretty much what I did is while they were out in the water, I started shooting them with trank arrows. Now, Godzilla was first and then Gertrude, and I kind of stumbled upon Gertrude on accident, but Godzilla was out. If you look out there, you'll see those rocks. Godzilla was literally straight out from those rocks and to the right a little bit. I was just out on, as a matter of fact, I put Ben down there on the shore so he wouldn't get killed. And I swam across the water, not really even looking for a dinosaur to get. I was just kind of like testing out the settings changes I had made. And I seen him, so I started shooting tranks at him. And I probably put 5 or 6 tranks in him before he even turned his head to come to me. And then, as he came to me, I kept pumping him with tranks. I mean, just kept pumping them. And then he finally got out of the water and made it to me. And by the time he got to me, he hit me literally like 3 times. And I tranked him. It took me about, I don't know, 45 minutes to tame him. Did not take very long at all. Now, granted, I also did the whole narcotics and stimulant trick, plus with prime meat. I got lucky, and there was a whole boatload of stegos, like, right there. And I literally would pump him full of narcotics. And run over and kill a stegosaurus or two, get some prime meat, come back, pump him, let him eat those two, and then just rinse and repeat. So I tamed him really fast. So then he and I were running along the coast, and Gertrude was way down there out in the middle of the water, and I put him on neutral, told him to quit following, and did pretty much the same exact thing. And she tamed in about 50 minutes or so. So within 2 hours, which is half the time that you would normally need to tame one Spino, I managed to tame 2 Spinos. So, and that got me to level 60, and then I can make, whatchamacallits, saddles for them. So what we're going to do, this video has been a very talky video, and I know that, and I'm sorry for it, but, and I'm actually not going to proceed with going further on this video, because it's not going to be a 30-minute video, and there's no need for a 30-minute video. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to cut. I want to end the video right here, and we'll end it here. And if you guys have any questions whatsoever about the server, it is a private server, and it's only me on the server as of right now. So, and I did not want to ride you. I want to get this poo ball. So it's just me right now. So I'm really not affecting anyone by making my changes, but I am recording on this server, so, I thought you guys had a right to know. Maybe you guys want to, change this, maybe you guys want to change your settings that you have on your, on your privately owned server. I don't know. If you do, just yell at me. If you don't have that pack, I can, give you a Dropbox link or something like that to it so you can have it. It helps out a lot, actually. I mean, it there's a lot of, not really syntax, but there's a lot of, things that have to go right. I need to turn this torch off. So, but yeah, guys. So, that's going to be that. It's going to be the end of this video. You guys like the video? If you like it, I mean, hit the like button. Share it, please. And if you're not already following my channel, hit that subscribe button. Follow. We're going to get into something very, very, very interesting on the next few episodes. I got some things that's in store for the next few episodes. So yeah, most definitely hit that subscribe button. And until next time, guys, this is Razzle, and I'm out of here.